Thanks for tuning in at Brackies.
Hello everyone and welcome to the first video in how to program in C Sharp. This course is going to be quite different from what I normally do, which is game development tutorials, but I've been getting a lot of requests on making a course that really focuses on the C Sharp language. And this is super awesome because it will allow us to really give an introduction to what programming means and reading and writing and understanding code whilst learning a language that can pretty much be used for any kind of software development, whether you want to do web development, whether you want to develop for PC or Mac, or game development, or a mobile app development. C# pretty much does it all by now. So C# is super cool and we're going to really focus on the language and understanding it. So what we're going to be doing today is, first off, what can C# do? We just went through that. Then we're going to be talking about console applications. What is an IDE? We're going to install the software we're going to be using throughout the course, and we're going to create our first project. If all of this seems very easy and fundamental to you, please just go ahead and skip on to the next video where we will delve into the programming side. So first off, let me explain what kind of software we are going to be writing in this course. So we're going to be making what is called console applications. And if you don't know what this is, there's an image on the screen right now. I agree with you that it does not look very appealing, but it's great for really focusing on the general language because it's not so specific on game development tools or mobile app tools or anything. It's a lot of language, but not much API. So the API stands for Application Programming Interface, and it's basically a series of commands that you can use. So game development uses one kind of API, and other software development uses other kinds of APIs. So that's a really simplified way of looking at it, but I think it will work for now. So an IDE also sounds really frightening. It is really not. It stands for Integrated Development Environment, and it's basically just the software that you use to programming. So if you're a video editor, you might use Premiere Pro or Sony Vegas. And if you're a programmer, you might use Visual Studio, Xcode, or what we are going to be using, which is Mono Develop. And it's even an extended version of Mono Develop called Xamarin Studio. So when you learn this, you can also do app development right after. So we're going to be using Mono Develop and in an extended version called Xamarin Studio. Just so you know, they are basically the same thing. Just don't get them confused. You just need to know that they might use different naming sometimes. So let's delve right into it and install our first IDE. So let's head over to our browser and let's open up monodevelop.com. Let's hit download now to download the file. But first we have to select an operating system. So if you're on Mac, click that and make sure you first install this package down here, which will download the Mono framework plus GTK. What these does is not important for now, but you need them, so download them and install them. And then right after, you can download and install Mono Develop itself. We're on Windows, so we're going to select that. And here you will need to first install GTK for .NET and then the .NET framework. So download both of them and install them. And then right after, we can download the installer itself. So I'm going to hit download, and it will start downloading. And you can see now it's not called Mono Develop anymore. Now it's called Xamarin Studio. So that's why I wanted to clear that up. So when it's downloaded, simply open it. And we will run the installer here. I'm just going to change my directory because I have a secondary hard disk, which I would rather have it sit on. So Xamarin Studio. Let's hit OK. Next. And it's going to install. The reason why we hit yes here. The reason why we're using Xamarin Studio is because it's cross-platform, which is really awesome. Visual Studio is only for Windows. It's made by Microsoft. And Xcode is only for Mac, and it's made by Apple. They're both good takes, but I mean, for what we're going to be doing here, which is consular applications, Xamarin Studio is going to be more than enough. So hit launch Xamarin Studio and hit finish. And it might go ahead and prompt you here to update. It often just pops up and say, hey, there's some updates. Do you want to install? And simply just hit install and restart, I think it's called, and you will be good to go. It's always great to keep your software updated. So we're going to go ahead and click new solution. And solutions are basically like projects, if you think of them in that respect. So let's hit new solution. And we are going to be making a console project in the C# language. So let's hit hit under C#. Click on the C# category. We can also do F# or VBNet or other stuff. And then hit console project. And when you have this selected, we are going to do a name. So let's call this first console project. And we're just going to keep the solution name the same as the name. And I'm just going to change the location to be on the desktop. And let's hit create directory for solution. And let's hit OK. Let's actually do solution name first console project solution, just so we keep them separate, because you can have several projects under one solution. Nah, it's not really important for this tutorial, but let's just name it correctly from the beginning. It's not good to teach bad habits. So let's hit OK. And it will start creating our project. And now this right here is our first C# program. So this here is C#. It might look very frightening and difficult to understand at this very moment. But in the next video, we are gonna go through everything, explain it. We are gonna write some code ourselves, and we are gonna launch our first console program. So that's gonna be really awesome. I hope you're looking forward to it as much as I am. It's always fun to play around with these console apps. And yeah, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.